Hey guys, I hope you all are doing well. So today we are going to talk about heathenism because I know that many of you guys are curious about heathenism and I thought I would make a short video giving you a little info to help you decide if you are interested in pursuing this particular pagan path. So get cozy, we are going to jump right in. So heathenry, also called heathenism or Germanic paganism, is a modern pagan religion. And it was developed in Europe in the early 20th century, and its practitioners model it on the pre-Christian belief systems of the Germanic peoples in the Iron Age and the early Middle Ages. So heathens work to reconstruct these past belief systems using surviving historical, archaeological, and folkloric research from this particular time period. And among some of the historical sources used are the Old Norse texts such as the Prose Edda and the Poetic Edda, as well as some Old English texts like Beowulf. Now, reconstructing religious practices from texts like these can be very difficult because these texts were written primarily by Christians. So obviously they are going to be biased and fragmented. And this is an issue that many pagan reconstructionists face because a lot of information was not written by the pagans, but by the Christians after the conversion. So that is something to keep in mind if you are going to be following this path, that any text you read, please take it with a grain of salt. So heathenry does not have a unified theology, but in general, it's polytheistic and it centers around a pantheon of deities from pre-Christian Germanic Europe. And some of the main deities from heathenism are Tyr, Odin, Thor, Frigg, and Freya from Scandinavian sources, as well as Wodan and Ystar from Anglo-Saxon sources. Some practitioners adopt the belief from Norse paganism that there are two sets of deities, the Aesir and the Vanir. And some people blend the different pre-Christian religions of the Scandinavian and Germanic peoples. And they might use a mix of Old English and Old Norse names for the deities, such as Odin versus Wotan, while others keep them very separate and only venerate deities from a particular region. Those who focus more on Scandinavian regional deities might refer to their practice as Asatru or Norse paganism, as opposed to heathenry or Germanic paganism. So when it comes to faith, most heathen practitioners are what's called hard polytheists, believing in the literal existence of the deities as individual entities. While some express a kind of more psychological interpretation of the divinities, viewing them as more symbols or as Jungian archetypes. And that's something you'll find in many different pagan religions, where some are going to be hard polytheists and some are more soft polytheists. And like the Greek and Roman pantheons, heathen deities are not seen as perfect, omnipotent, or omnipresent. And instead, they're viewed as having their own strengths and weaknesses. Heathens view their connection with their deities as being that not of master and servant, but more so as an interdependent relationship, kind of akin to a family. And this concept is very different from the Abrahamic religions, which view God as this kind of omnipotent master that demands faith and service. And along with honoring the gods, heathens tend to have an animistic view of the cosmos, and they believe that the natural world is imbued with different types of spirits. Kind of similar to Shintoism, where you do have certain main deities in Shintoism, but there's also a wide array of spirits in the natural world as well. In heathenism, the deities and spirits are honored in sacrificial rites known as bloats, in which food and libations are offered to them. And some practitioners also engage in rituals and practices designed to induce an altered state of consciousness or induce visions, such as the cedar, for example. And this is for the purposes of gaining wisdom and advice from the deities. And like many pagan religions, beliefs about the afterlife are varied, and they're also rarely emphasized. There's more of a focus on your actions here and now in this world than where you may end up after death. In fact, ethics are considered to be an important part of heathenism, and modern heathen groups tend to emphasize honor, personal integrity, and loyalty. Now, I should probably mention that some aspects of heathenry do have a bit of a dark past. So the origins of heathenry lie in the 19th and 20th century Romantic period, which glorified pre-Christian societies of Germanic Europe. And groups actively venerating the deities of these societies appeared in Germany and Austria during the early 1900s, and there was a connection between the veneration of these European deities and the rise of the Nazi Party. Although these groups, known as the Völkisch movement, largely dissolved following Nazi Germany's defeat in World War II. And then a little bit later on in the 1970s, new heathen groups started to become established in Europe and North America. So there is kind of a division within the modern heathen movement that has emerged surrounding the concept of race. So some heathen groups known as Völkisch within the community view heathenry as an ethnic religion with inherent links to the Germanic race. They believe it should be reserved for white people of Northern European descent and often combine their religious heathen views with a right-wing perspective. Now, a much larger portion of heathens instead adopt a universalist perspective, holding that the religion of heathenry is open to all, irrespective of ethnic or racial identity. So there is a bit of a tension here between these two kind of modern groups within heathenism, though I don't want that to discourage anyone if they feel that they are really drawn to these particular deities. And I feel like you can definitely follow this path and avoid some of the messier political issues surrounding it. So do keep that in mind. I just thought it was something that I should mention in this video. So there are also a lot of great YouTubers that dig into these topics in more detail, such as Jackson Crawford, Aerith Hagar, and May K. Hella. So I will link their channels down below in case you'd like to dig a little deeper into heathenism. So I love to hear from you guys. I want to know what your thoughts are about heathenism. Is this a pagan path that appeals to you? So comment down below. I'm looking forward to reading all of your responses, and I will see you all next week. Talk to you later. Bye.